I knew that cancer was complex, but I didn't realize how complex until I heard them talk about it. And it humbled me that there's so much that I don't know and there's so much more that needs to be done. But it also inspired me to say, okay, there is something that my expertise can contribute.
Our lab has been studying this modification in RNA called inosine. And inosine modification is essential for life, but it's dysregulated in cancer and neurological disease. We had developed some new tools that could allow us to detect this modification, but all of the tools we had developed required us to take a plate with cells in it and break open all of those cells and then pool all of their RNA together. And we lose a lot of important information when we do that.
You know, I will say, it's kind of like a tango. You know, like, you're the one in lab, like, you're planning the experiments, you're showing your advisor, they're giving you feedback. You kind of both go through the process of, it kind of worked, but it didn't work. Okay, we're troubleshooting this, and we're troubleshooting that. And you kind of go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. We had had some encouraging data that the workflow was working, but we had finally reached that experiment where we were really going to put it to the test. I had set up my sample on the microscope. I turned on the laser. I looked into the microscope and I saw the fluorescence. I saw the glowing edited RNA and I was so ecstatic. I was thrilled. My immediate reaction was, what can we do with it now?
What Alex's technology allows us to do is to see the modifications in the RNA when it's still in the cells. That's going to be really powerful for being able to study the role of this modification in cancer and all of these other diseases.
I never imagined that I could contribute in such a significant way. The quicker that patients can have that early detection of potential disease, the quicker they can be treated and the better care that they can receive.